At Kitty Cat General, every doctor has their fair share of bad news to deliver.
Things will go missing, like a pair of scissors or even a kidney. Often it is much worse.
Every doctor has a story like these, but this story is about Dr. Snorts' worst day ever.
8 years ago, Dr. Snorts was on call as an obstetrician, a job he adored.
There's not much to it, really. You just have to be good at catching and know when to talk and when to stay quiet.
Everyone in town knew about Mustard Relish. She was the only woman who would have fallen in love with a beard.
Unfortunately, he was in a decent beard and skipped tiring when Mustard became pregnant.
She was due any minute, and Dr. Schnortz was eager to meet the baby beard.
Auntie Ping Pong Ball had been caring for Mustard Relish and joined her at the hospital.
The following day, she would be marrying her high-powered washing machine, so Auntie brought along her wedding dress just in case.
The nurses got Mustard comfortable with pillows and banana-flavored laughing gas.
When it became clear the baby Mustard wasn't coming this night, Dr. Schwartz left for the evening.
As she made her exit, the baby beard began to appear.
Auntie Ping Pong Ball slipped to the lights and the lights went out and the room began to shake.
When the earthquake stopped, the lights came back on. Dr. Nort readied himself once again for the delivery.
A nurse came to his side and said in a hushed voice, Dr. Nort, where's the baby?
Dr. Snorts looked down into his empty hands, realizing the bearded baby wasn't there.
He checked under the bed and in the food cart and in the bathroom.
The aftermath of the earthquake was the perfect cover for Dr. Snorchel's panic.
After 2 hours of frantic searching, Dr. Snorts knew he had no choice but to tell Mustard Relish he could not find the baby.
Just as he put his hand on the doorknob, he ran into the hospital's chief of security, Bobby.
Dr. Schnortz asked Bobby to review the security tapes from during the earthquake.
Examining the footage, they quickly noticed something strange about Auntie Ping Pong Ball's exit and the strange object sticking out of her bag.
They watched as she had thrown her bag on top of her car, the bearded baby became a stowaway.
Her car raced through the traffic with no regard for the lights.
Hopeless, Dr. Snorts turned away from the footage and walked back to the hospital.
Meanwhile, Auntie Ping Pong Ball's car had a near miss with the tractor, causing the baby to fly off the roof.
The baby landed next to a raccoon who dragged the baby into a nearby pasture on old McGregor's farm.
Jebediah McGregor hated most everyone and everything, but above all, he hated trespassers.
He couldn't shoot trespassers with a gun, but he could shoot them out of a cannon.
Just as Dr. Snort was making his way to the hospital's entrance, he heard what sounded like crying from above.
Without thinking, Dr. Snort opened his arms and miraculously caught the falling bearded baby.
He raced to Mustard Relish's hospital room, and the nurses couldn't believe their eyes. As the doctor handed the bundle to the new mama,
"This is the best day of my life."